चैप्टर नाइन क्राइम थ्योरीज टू अंडरस्टैंड क्रिमिनल जस्टिस इट इज नेसेसरी टू अंडरस्टैंड क्राइम. मोस्ट पॉलिसी मेकिंग इन क्रिमिनल जस्टिस इज बेस्ड ऑन क्रिमिनोलॉजिकल थ्योरीज वेदर द पीपल मेकिंग दोज पॉलिसीज नोन इट और नॉट. इन फैक्ट most of the failed policies in criminal justice are due to misinterpretation, partial implementation or ignorance of criminological theory. Much time and money could be saved if only policy makers had a thorough understanding of criminological theory. At one time criminological theory was rather pure or abstract with few practical implications, but that is not the case anymore. For example, almost all criminologists today use a legalistic rather than normative definition of crime. A legalistic definition of crime takes as its starting point the statutory definitions contained in the penal code, legal statutes or ordinances. A crime is a crime because the law says so. Sure, there are concerns about over-criminalization and under-criminalization, but at least on the surface, a legalistic approach seems practical. It is also advantageous to normative definition, which sees crime as a violation of norms, social standards of how human ought to think and behave. Although there are times when criminology can shed light on norms and norms violators. Every criminological theory contains a set of assumptions about human disposition, social structure, and principles of causation. To name a few, a description of the phenomena to be explained, and an explanation or prediction of that phenomenon. The assumptions are also called meta-theoretical issues and deal with debates like those over free will versus determinism or consensus versus conflict. The description is a statistical profile, figure, diagram, or table of numbers representing the patterns and correlates of the crime taken as an exemplar, most appropriate example of all crime. The explanation is a set of variables, things that can be tweaked or changed, arranged in some kind of causal order as that they have statically and meaningfully significance. Criminological theories are primarily concerned with etiology, but occasionally have important things to say about actors in the criminal justice system, such as police, attorneys, correctional personnel, and victims. Types of theories of crime. There are basically 13 identifiable types of criminological theory, only 3 of which are considered mainstream or conventional criminology: strain, learning, control. The oldest theory, biochemistry, goes back to 1876 AD, and the last 4 theories, लेफ्ट रियलिज्म पीस मेकिंग फेमिनिस्ट पोस्ट मॉडर्न हैव ओनली डेवलप्ड इन द पास्ट 30 ईयर्स द फॉलोइंग टेबल इलस्ट्रेट्स विद मोर इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट ईच थ्योरी बिलो द टेबल नंबर वन बायोकेमिस्ट्री थ्योरी बायोकेमिस्ट्री कॉजेस हेरिडिटी विटामिन डेफिशिएंसी एलर्जी ट्यूमर टॉक्सिन ब्रेन डिसफंक्शन हार्मोनल इम्बैलेंस पॉलिसी पैराडाइम आइसोलेशन ट्रीटमेंट नंबर टू थ्योरी साइकोलॉजी थ्योरी कॉजेस लो इंटेलिजेंस साइकोपैथी स्ट्रेस पॉलिसी पैराडाइम ट्रीटमेंट काउंसलिंग नंबर थ्री थ्योरी इकोलॉजी थ्योरी कॉजेस डिसऑर्गेनाइज्ड नेबरहुड्स पॉलिसी पैराडाइम कम्युनिटी एम्पावरमेंट फोर स्ट्रेन थ्योरी कॉजेस इकोनॉमिक गोल ब्लॉकेज पॉलिसी पैराडाइम इंक्रीज्ड अपॉर्चुनिटीज फाइव लर्निंग थ्योरी कॉजेस इमिटेशन रीइंफोर्समेंट शेड्यूल्स पॉलिसी पैराडाइम मोर इफेक्टिव नेगेटिव रीइंफोर्समेंट मोर यूज ऑफ पॉजिटिव रीइंफोर्समेंट सिक्स थ्योरी कंट्रोल थ्योरी कॉजेस सोशलाइजेशन लो सेल्फ कंट्रोल पॉलिसी पैराडाइम चाइल्ड रेयरिंग सोशल बॉन्ड्स सेवन थ्योरी लेबलिंग थ्योरी कॉजेस शनिंग आइडेंटिटी इमर्जन पॉलिसी पैराडाइम नॉन इंटरवेंशन री इंटीग्रेशन एट थ्योरी कंफ्लिक्ट थ्योरी कॉजेस पावर डिफरेंशियल्स कंपिटिशन पॉलिसी पैराडाइम इंक्रीज्ड इक्वालिटी नाइन थ्योरी रेडिकल थ्योरी कॉजेस क्लास स्ट्रगल कैपिटलिज्म पॉलिसी पैराडाइम प्रैक्सिस सोशलिज्म टेन थ्योरी लेफ्ट रियलिज्म थ्योरी कॉजेस प्रीडेटरी रिलेशनशिप पॉलिसी पैराडाइम मोर इफेक्टिव पॉलिसी प्रोटेक्शन मोर इफेक्टिव पुलिस प्रोटेक्शन 11 थ्योरी पीस मेकिंग थ्योरी कॉजेस इनर सफरिंग एंड टर्मोइल पॉलिसी पैराडाइम स्पिरिचुअल रिजुविनेशन 12 थ्योरी फेमिनिस्ट थ्योरी कॉजेस जेंडर इनइक्वालिटी पैट्रियार्की पॉलिसी पैराडाइम एंड सेक्स डिस्क्रिमिनेशन 13 थ्योरी पोस्ट मॉडर्न थ्योरी कॉजेस हायरार्कियल प्रिविलेजेस एंड लैंग्वेज पॉलिसी पैराडाइम मोर इनफॉर्मल सोशल कंट्रोल बायोकेमिस्ट्री थ्योरी 1 बायोकेमिस्ट्री थ्योरी बायोकेमिस्ट्री इज नोन बाय मैनी नेम्स बायोलॉजिकल कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल हैविंग टू डू विद द बॉडीज मॉर्फोलॉजी जेनेटिक एंड एंथ्रोपोलॉजिकल क्रिमिनोलॉजी द ओल्डेस्ट फील्ड इज क्रिमिनल एंथ्रोपोलॉजी फाउंडेड बाय द फादर ऑफ मॉडर्न क्रिमिनोलॉजी सीजर लोम्ब्रोसो सीजर लोम्ब्रोसो इन 1876 He was one of the first exponents of the positivist approach to explaining crime. Positivism meaning a search for the causes of crime using scientific method. as opposed to the classical approach, which relies upon free will as the main cause of crime. Historically, theories of the biochemistry type have tried to establish the biological inferiority of criminals. But modern biocriminology simply says that heredity and body organ dysfunctions produce a predisposition toward crime. 2. Psychological criminology theory. Psychological criminology has been around since 1914 and attempts to explain the consistent finding that is an 8-point IQ difference between criminals and non-criminals. That gap is not enough to notice, but it might make them more impulsive and foolhardy. And even smart people with high IQs are vulnerable to folly. Others are psychopaths, sociopaths, and antisocial personalities. 3. Ecological criminology theory. Ecological criminology was the first sociological criminology, developed during the 1920s at the Department of Sociology at the University of Chicago. Hence, it is also called Chicago School Sociology. Ecology is the study of relationships between an organism and its environment. And this type of theory explains crime by the kind of people who live there. 4. Strain theory. Sometimes called by the French word anomie, is a 1938 American version of French sociology, invented by the father of modern sociology, Emile Durkheim, 1858 to 1917. This type of theory sees crime as the normal result of an American dream in which people set their aspirations for wealth, education, occupation, any status symbol too high and inevitably discover strain or goal blockages along the way. The only two things to do are to reduce aspirations or increase opportunities. 5. Learning theories. Learning theories tend to follow the lead of Edwin Sutherland's theory of differential association, developed in 1947. Although ideas about imitation or modeling go back to 1890, often oversimplified as peer group theories. Learning is much more than that and involves the analysis of what is positively and negatively rewarding, reinforcing for individuals. 6. Control theories. Control theories in criminology are all about social control. Only those called containment or low self-control theories have to do with individual psychology. Control theory has pretty much dominated the criminological landscape since 1969. It focuses upon a person's relationships to their agents of socialization, such as parents, teachers, preachers, coaches, scout leaders, or police officers. It studies how effective bonding with such authority figures translates into bonding with society. Hence, keeping people out of trouble with the law. 7. Labeling theory. 7. Labeling theory. Labeling theory was a child of the 1960s and 1970s. Saw criminals as underdogs who initially did something out of the ordinary and then got swept up in a huge government-sponsored labeling or shunning reaction. It argues that anyone facing such an overwhelming negative labeling social reaction will eventually become more like the able, because that is the only way out of their identity formation. It points out that sometimes it's best to do nothing for minor offending, and that there are few reintegrate rituals designed to help people fit back into their communities. 8. Conflict theory. 8. Conflict theory. Conflict theory holds that society is based on conflict between competing interest groups. For example, rich against poor, management against labor, whites against minorities, men against women, adults against children, etc. These kinds of dog-eat-dog theories also have their origins in the 1960s and 1970s and are characterized by the study of power and powerlessness. 9. Radical theories. 9. Radical theories. Radical theories, also from the 1960s and 1970s, typically involved Marxist, referring to Karl Marx 1818 to 1883, critiques of capitalist society which allows things to exist like millions of billionaires while the vast majority of people live in poverty or just get by. Such fundamental economic disparities reflect basic contradictions in the way work is organized into demoralizing and oppressive condition. Crime is seen as a reflection of class struggle, a kind of primitive rebellion, with criminals behaving as rebels without a clue. Only through praxis, informed action based on theoretical understanding, will the new socialist society be formed and crime will go away. 10. Left realism theory. 10. Left realism theory. Left realism is a mid-1980s British development that focuses upon the reasons why people of the working class prey upon one another. That is, victimize other poor people of their own kind. It wants the police to have more power in protecting poor people. But on the other hand, does not want the police to be invasive or intrusive. 11. Peacemaking criminological theory. 11. Peacemaking criminological theory. Peacemaking criminology came about during the 1990s as the study of how wars on crime only make matters worse. It suggests that the solution to crime is to create more caring, mutually dependent communities and strive for inner rebirth or spiritual rejuvenation. Inner peace. 12. Feminist criminological theory. 12. Feminist criminological theory. Feminist criminology natured. Feminist criminology matured in the 1990s, although feminist ideas have been around for decades. The central concept is patriarchy or male domination as the main cause of crime. Feminists also tend to call for more attention to female points of view. 13. Postmodern criminological theory. 13. Postmodern criminological theory. Postmodern criminology matured in the 1990s, although postmodernism itself as a rejection of scientific rationality to the pursuit of knowledge was born in the late 1960s. It tends to focus upon how stereotypical words, thoughts, and conceptions limit our understanding and how crime develops from feelings of being disconnected and dehumanized. It advocates replacing our current legal system with informal social controls such as group and neighborhood tribunals. This has been only the briefest of overviews on crime theories. There is much, much more, and the reader is encouraged to find out more, including the comparative advantages and weaknesses of different theories. Reasons for criminalizing actions. Crimes are viewed as offenses against society and as such are punished by the state. They can be socialistically distinguished depending on the passive subject of the crime, the victim, or on the offended interest in crimes against. 1. The personality of the state. 2. The public administration. 3. The religious sentiment and the pity for death. 4. The public order. 5. The public economy, industry and commerce. 6. The public morality. 7. The person and honor. 8. The patrimony. Or they can be distinguished depending on the related punishment, then on the degree of offense that the forbidden behavior caused in derelicts and violations. The definition of a crime generally reflects the current attitudes prevalent in a society. For example, possession of drugs was not always a crime, while the prohibition era made alcohol illegal. Classification of crimes. Crimes can be divided into several categories. Computer offenses, crimes against persons, crimes against property, crimes against state security, drug offenses, sexual offenses, and weapon offenses. Crimes are also grouped by severity. Some common categorical terms being felonies, indictable offenses, misdemeanors, and summary offenses. For convenience, infractions are also usually included in such lists, although they are not subject of planned or attempted crime, which the offender was not able to carry out prior to arrest. The following are crimes in many jurisdictions: arson, conspiracy, homicide, theft, cannibalism, domestic violence, extortion, home invasion, larceny, postal fraud, robbery, trespass, assault, criminal threatening, murder, breaking and entering, child sexual abuse, drug possession, forgery, identity theft, libel, prostitution, slanders, weapon possession, battery, grave, perjury, treason, carjacking, embezzlement, fraud, illegal gambling, looting, racketeering, smuggling, usury, blackmail, robbing, tax evasion, burglary, counterfeiting, espionage, genocide, kidnapping, manslaughter, rape, stalking, vandalism. Study. Matters related to criminal behavior in society are studied in the field of sociology on the subfield of criminology, and a person who studies this is called a criminologist. The mental state and acuity of criminals is assessed by psychologists, especially in cases wherein the insanity defense is being utilized. The study of crime in general across a number of functional disciplines is often known as crime science. This draws on statistics, environmental design, forensics, policing, sociology, and other sciences to analyze the crimes rather than the offenders, and provides ways and means to prevent, detect, and solve crimes. History. History. The first civilization had codes of law, though these codes were not always recorded. The first known written codes were written by the ancient Sumerians, and it was probably their king Ur-Nammu, reigning on Ur in the 21st century BC, the first legislator of which we received a formal system in 32 articles. It has to be recalled that this is not among the eldest laws, since not all the ancient laws are penal rules. In the antiquity, in fact, codes mostly contained both civil and penal rules together. Sumerians, however, later issued other codes as the one known as Codes of Lippitstar. Last king of the third dynasty of Ur listened
20th century BC. This code contains some 50 articles and has been reconstructed by the comparison among several sources. In Babylon, the code of Isnuna before and the code of Hammurabi, one of the richest ones of ancient times after, were used and reflected society's belief that law was derived from the will of the gods. Similarly, some codes of conduct of religious origins or references have been included in penal codes. Forbidden behavior resulting in real crimes in the states ruled by theocracy, even in more recent times. Measuring the extent of crime. Measuring the extent of crime. The development of accurate measures of crime has been the most difficult task by criminologists and those engaged in law enforcement. The oldest US statistical analysis of certain types of crimes is the Uniform Crime Report, UCR, which has been issued annually since 1930 by the Federal Bureau of Investigation. Individual law enforcement agencies are responsible for the collection of the crime data assembled by the FBI. The statistics measure only crime known to the police. In order for the police to be included in the UCR, it must have been reported to the police by the victim or a witness, or directly observed by the police themselves. The most well-known portion of the UCR is the crime index, in which 8 major crime categories are listed: murder, rape, robbery, aggravated assault, burglary, larceny, motor vehicle theft, and arson. Data is also included on the age, sex, and race of persons arrested. The percentages of crimes that are cleared by arrest, clearance rate, and the rate of crime per 1 lakh US inhabitants. For 1985, the UCR revealed that the number of reported index crimes had increased by 4.6% over the previous year following 3 years of decline. Murder and non-vigilant manslaughter increased 1.5%, forcible rape went up by 4%, and the total of aggravated assaults rose by 5.5%. Violent crime climbed by 5% overall, while crimes against property were up by 4%. The latter category included a 7% rise in motor vehicle theft. The FBI reported that the 1985 rise was disproportionately distributed geographically. The Midwest had no increase, but crime levels rose 9% in the South, 5% in the West, and 2% in the Northeast. Arrests in 1985 totaled 11.9 million, an increase of 3%. A great deal of criticism has been directed at the UCR statistics. The data it is charged is open to manipulation by law enforcement agencies that have a vested interest in demonstrating reduced crime rates or in obtaining more funds should crime rates be shown to have risen. Some doubt exists as to whether all the reporting agencies count the same offense in the same manner. Perhaps the most common complaint is that the figures change along the changing police practices. If a police agency were to concentrate on apprehending the sellers of stolen goods, or if citizens begin to report all robbery or theft incidents, the number of index crime in those categories would rise sharply. In order to counteract this problem, the US Bureau of Justice Statistics issues the National Crime Survey, NCS, an annual report on household crime victimization based on census surveys rather than on individuals' complaints to law enforcement officials. It is believed that these interview surveys give a more accurate picture of the amount of crime that occurs by uncovering unreported crimes. In fact, statistics for 1983 revealed that only 45% of personal crimes and 48% of property or household crimes had been reported to the police that year. While the UCR generally depicts a rising crime rate over the extended periods of years, the NCS gives a different picture. The most common complaint is that the survey is dependent upon the sometimes faulty memory of the respondents. The victim of a crime is likely to recall the event as if it had occurred recently. And as a consequence, some respondents report crimes that occurred prior to the year with which the interview is concerned. Compared with other countries that keep crime statistics, the United States has the highest rate per 1 lakh population for reported murders, rape, and robberies. It is important to remember, however, that the incidence of crime is influenced by such factors as industrialization, urbanization, drug and alcohol abuse, unemployment, and availability of firearms. Many of these factors, of course, are present in other countries. The US population, however, possesses more firearms than any other population group and has an extremely high rate of alcohol and drug abuse. Also, the effect of periods of high unemployment, such as the late 1970s and early 1980s, and the influence of television and movie representations of violence. In fact, the nagging question of violence as an American culture phenomenon are issues that have not yet been definitely studied. Criminology and theories of the causes of crime. Criminology and theories of the causes of crime. Criminology is the scientific study of crime and criminal behavior. Although there are several contemporary schools of criminological theory, they all share a common goal: the search for the causes of criminal behavior in the hope that this information can be transformed into policies that will be effective in handling or even eliminating crime. The earliest criminologists, this classical school, were late 18th century thinkers concerned with humanizing the highly arbitrary and harsh systems of criminal punishment of the time. The Italian economist Cesare Bonacina Beccaria and the English philosopher Jeremy Bentham both emphasized the deterrent effect of punishment on potential criminals. The theory evolved by the classical school posits the existence of a rational humanity that possesses free will and whose primary motivation is to maximize pleasure and minimize pain. Classical theorists reasoned that if a rational person knows that a particular painful punishment will almost certainly follow the commission of a particular crime, he or she will not commit the crime. This line of thought led to the attempt to establish elaborate categorical systems in which each crime had its punishment equivalent. Let the punishment fit the crime, and which prefigured the fixed term sentences that are increasingly being imposed today. In addition, the classical belief that everyone has the capacity to make rational choices still influences the field of criminology. A later influential body of criminological thought was the positivist or Italian school, founded in the late 19th century by the Italian psychiatrist and anthropologist Cesar Lombroso. Responding to the new evolutionary theories of Charles Darwin, Lombroso embarked on a detailed physiological study of convicts in order to determine if the criminal behavior was biologically determined. Lombroso found that his convicts possesses certain physical characteristics to a greater degree than the general population. Although his findings were later refuted, his use of the scientific method and its emphasis on the multiple environmental causes of crime had great impact on criminology and the development of the idea of rehabilitation. The biological approach pioneered by Lombroso is used today in such studies as the link between learning disabilities and crime, and the relationship between diet and assaultive behavior. 20th century criminologists have been profoundly influenced by the work of such sociologists as Durkheim, 1858 to 1917, by the psychological theories of Sigmund Freud, 1856 to 1939, and his followers, and by the case study approach inspired by Freud and first used by criminologists in the 1920s in work on juvenile delinquency, where possible environmental and genetic causes of criminal behavior were examined. In the 1930s, Edwin H. Sutherland propounded his theory of differential association, which attributed the genesis of criminality to the social environment and genesis of criminality to the social environment of the offender. Sutherland believes that criminal behavior is learned behavior, and that persons who live in a social milieu that contain more criminals than law-abiding citizens are likely to become criminals themselves. This line of thought led Sutherland and his followers to the conclusion that some transformation of the social structure is necessary in order to eliminate what they believe to be the root causes of crime. Theorists of the radical or Marxist school of criminology believe that the ruling classes designate certain types of behavior as criminal in an attempt to secure and maintain the capitalist system. Thus, the criminal justice system is in their eyes largely a means to maintain the status quo by suppressing the proletariat. This school also calls for change in the social structure in order to eliminate crime. Another social structural theory, labeling theory, relates to the manner in which criminal law is enforced and is primarily concerned with the explanation of juvenile delinquency and the commission of status offenses, that is, acts that are considered to be criminal if committed by juvenile, but are not considered criminal if committed by an adult. Running away, for example, is a status offense. Enforcement of the punishment for a status offense, it was found, could lead to a juvenile's committing further and more serious offenses. In fact, enforcement of the law created rather than prevented crime. This theory has been influential in the decriminalization of most status offenses. Although decriminalization has produced further problems. If the police cannot arrest a runaway juvenile, they also do not possess the power to hold him or her for treatment for obvious drug problems or ill health. At present, it appears that the emphasis in criminological studies is moving away from investigations of individual motivation. It is because criminologists bring more attention to bear on the ways in which criminal law is made and enforced. The probable effects of present-day criminal justice practices and the potential consequences of changes in criminal law enforcement are shifting over to new paradigms. Theories of crime. Old theories, traditional, 1876 to 1890. Chemistry, biological, constitutional, genetic, anthropological, Cesar Lombroso, 1876. Learning, 1890, peer group. Old theories, traditional, 1876 to 1890. Next one is, second is, middle period theories, 1914 to 1969. Middle period theories, 1914 to 1969. Psychological, 1914. Ecological, 1920. Social control, 1969. Anomie strain, 1938. Third, modern theories, 1960 to 1970. Modern theories, third, modern theories, 1960 to 1970. Labeling, 1960 to 1970. Radical, 1960 to 1970. Conflict, 1960 to 1970. Fourth, latest theories, 1980 to 1990. Fourth, latest theories, 1980 to 1990. Left realism, 1980. Peacekeeping, 1990. Postmodern, 1990. Feminist, 1990.
Thank you.